Good morning all. So welcome to the session on oscillators. Okay, so we are in the last section of the module 2. Okay, so I told you in the very beginning, so in module 2 I have 5 sections. The 3 sections belongs to MOSFET and the remaining 2 sections belongs to oscillator. In oscillator first part we have discussed the RC phase shift oscillator. Okay, so BJT based, FET based and all we have discussed. And we have determined the frequency of oscillation derivation. Okay, the same way. So now the last part or second part in the oscillator. So I need to write it here, the third, fifth section E. Okay, in my notes. So you can include this. Okay, not written. So the last section E. Okay, so LC and crystal oscillator. So both we are discussing here. Okay. So what is meant by LC? What is meant by RC? RC means in the feedback network, we had a resistor and capacitor combination, 3 cascaded section. Okay. So whereas a resistor is not a energy storing element, whereas capacitor was an energy storing element. Okay. That's why the 3 sections we required there. But in LC oscillator, it is inductor and capacitor combination. Okay. So how much inductor, how much capacitor, in which topology it should be connected so that it should give 180 degree phase shift so that it will produce the oscillations. Okay, so that we are discussing here in the first part. So today's discussion, and next, maybe next class, we will discuss the crystal oscillators. Okay, so oscillators utilizing transistors, FETs or BJTs with LC tuned circuits or crystals as feedback elements are used in the frequency range of 100 kilohertz to hundreds of megahertz. Okay, normally these oscillators are used in very high frequency. For example, your all communication applications. Okay, so whatever you are receiving calls, okay, or it may be the many communication aspect, the antenna what you are seeing, okay, towers, okay, so through which communication is happening there, okay, receiver is there, okay, so everywhere their oscillators are required, right? So there the frequency range is very high. Okay, we have the different range of frequency. RC type of oscillator, they are in less range compared to this less range oscillators. So in the frequency range of 100 kilohertz to megahertz range, so LC and crystal oscillators are used, and the LC tuned circuits or crystal will be used as the feedback element along with the amplifiers. Okay, amplifier may be FET or BJT as we have discussed earlier. Okay, so they exhibit higher Q. So higher Q means what? Q point. Okay, the DC point. Then the RC types. Okay, so then the RC type. However, LC oscillators are difficult to tune. So tuning is very difficult. That is one disadvantage. Over wide ranges, and crystal oscillators operate at a single frequency. Okay, for wide ranges, the crystal oscillators operate at a single frequency. So this is an introduction about the last section of oscillator, LC and crystal oscillators. So now today we'll focus on only LC oscillators and what are the types of oscillators we have in that category, and we'll do the detailed analysis. Okay. So LC tuned oscillators. Okay. So there are 2 sets of oscillators. They come under the category of LC tuned oscillators. Okay. So the figures are shown here as A and B, the 2 commonly used configurations of LC tuned oscillators. Okay, and these are given by some person. So accordingly their names, these oscillators are named. The figure A is called as the Colpitts oscillator. Okay, and figure B is called as the Hartley oscillator. Okay, because of their name, so because they have done some research, so if you connect this combination or pattern, we will get a oscillation. Okay, because of their invention, their names are given, Colpitts and Hartley oscillator. Okay, so what you have in the first figure, just look at. Okay, so we have not shown the amplifier part in completely. Okay, here this is a just configuration I am showing. Next we will see the practical circuit, how it looks like. Okay, so the for simplicity purpose, we have not shown the DC analysis and all. That means RD, RE, CE, all these connection we have not shown. Normally amplifier will be a voltage divider bias circuit or self bias circuit you will have. You have seen in previous. Okay, so that I have not shown. Just I have shown in BJT or FET. BJT I have shown. Okay, so this acts as the amplifier. Okay, so then at the amplifier output, Okay, so resistor is there. So it is nothing but it is including the internal resistance of the BJT along with the load. It will access. So here you will have the output of the amplifier. Okay, so this is the output V naught. So this is amplifier part one section. Okay, so oscillator, you know, amplifier along with the frequency selective network. So now the frequency selective network is LC oscillator, right? So it is having here single L in parallel with two capacitors. Okay, so C1, C2. So since two capacitor we have, okay, so this is how you can remember the circuit. Okay, so C1, C2 in parallel with L. So this is called as a tank circuit. Okay, so this is normally called as a tank circuit, and this is the commonly used in all the communication system applications. And output of this is given as input to the base of the transistor, that is the input, right? So this is a Colpitts oscillator configuration. Similarly, if you see Hartley oscillator, again same, you have the amplifier, a BJT or transistor. So load is there, and here you have the output. So now what is the change? Instead of single inductor, now I have two inductors and single capacitor. Okay, so you can easily identify the difference among those. Okay, so this is called as Hartley oscillator. So in exam you may confuse this. How you remember this? A simple thing is Colpitts oscillator means C is there, right? So starting letter is C. So you imagine here two C1, C2, two C are there. Okay, that means two capacitors are there, that somehow you have to remember. Okay, and here you have the H, Hartley oscillator. Okay, so H stands for normally Henry. Okay, belongs to inductor, right? So here two inductors will be there, like that you can remember. Okay, so it is no compulsion, that it is no rule. Okay, so I am only giving how I used to remember in my study days. Okay, so this is the two oscillators. So now we'll just try to give the frequency first. We'll give the introduction to both oscillator circuits. Then what I will do, I will take the detailed analysis of Colpitts oscillator, that is there in your book. Similarly, you can do the Hartley oscillator also, but it is there in book. That's why we will explain that part in detail. Okay. Both utilize a parallel LC circuit. Okay. So both are having LC circuit connected between collector and base. Collector is the output and base is the input. So that is the feedback part. There it is connected. Or in case if you have used a FET, it is between drain and the gate. Okay. So this you can identify. With a fraction of the tuned circuit voltage fed to the emitter. Okay, so there resistor is there. Okay, fraction of, in between this, we have given some fraction to the emitter part also. Okay, so emitter part it is connected, so only some fraction of voltage, feedback voltage, it will go to the emitter. Okay, so that is the meaning. This feedback is achieved by way of a capacitive divider in the Colpitts oscillator. Okay, see, that's why capacitive divider, that means two capacitors are there, and by way of an inductive divider in the Hartley circuit. Hartley, you have inductive divider, and in Colpitts circuit, you have the capacitive divider circuit. Okay, and in both circuits, the resistor R, so I've shown a resistor R after the transistor, right, models the combination of the losses of the inductors, the load resistance of the oscillator, and the output resistance of the transistor. So all together it is indicating by single R. What are those losses of the inductor? Because you are using an inductor there, and if you have studied the inductors in detail in basic electrical, so it is having a losses, right? So to reduce that, R is required. That R it will access. Then load resistance of the oscillator, complete oscillator circuit load is there now. It is also indicated by this R. And also the output resistance of the transistor. Okay, so that is the introduction to this circuit. So if we see how its frequency of oscillation looks like, so first I will show you the equation as we have done in RC phase shift oscillator. Okay, we have derived the frequency of oscillation 1/2 pi RC √6, right? Or in the case of BJT, 1/2 pi RC √6 + 4K. Okay. So same way, so you have the expression for these Hartley and Colpitts oscillator. You can derive those. Okay, so that I will show you first, and then we'll take the detailed one for Colpitts oscillator. Okay. Okay, if the frequency of operation is sufficiently low that we can neglect the transistor capacitances. The frequency of oscillation will be determined by the resonance frequency of the parallel tuned circuit. I told you, no, LC circuit normally, wherever if you look at, so it is called as normally tuned circuit. And this term, it will be used in your communication. For example, if you have used a FM radio, right? So you'll be tuning the frequency there. Okay, if you have seen the old radios, okay, even the your set-top box in your home, okay, there are knobs are there, you can rotate that. But once it is installed, they have set everything, okay? So everything there, tuning will be there, okay? All these high-end applications, even your radars, okay? So everything based on the tuning for the frequency. So that's why it is called as tank circuit, okay? Also known as tank circuit, why? Tank term, why we'll use? Water tank normally we'll use because it will store the energy, right? Same way, this L and C both are energy storing devices in the circuits. That's why it is called as their energy is there, okay? Oscillation starts from there, okay? So oscillation producing capacity is there. That's why it is called as a tank circuit name, okay? Because it behaves as a reservoir for energy storage. That's what the name, okay? So as we say water tank for reservoir of water, same way it is energy storage reservoir. That's why it is called the tank circuit, okay? So for Colpitts oscillator, if we derive, so you will get the frequency of oscillation in rate, angular frequency is given by 1 by square root of L, C1, C2 by C1 plus C2. That means the two capacitors are in series. So this is the expression for series, right? If two capacitors are in series, what is the equivalent you will get? C1, C2 by C1 plus C2. Okay, same way. And for the Hartley oscillator, we have omega naught 1 by square root of L1 plus L2 into C. So C is single, that's why it is outside. L1 plus L2 indicating inductors are in series. Okay, so very first I told you the series connection of elements. Okay, so what is the expression? So this is you can derive for Hartley and this is you can derive for Colpitts oscillator. Okay, along with the frequency of oscillation, there is another factor is there. What is that? Even previously also we have done, that is the feedback factor beta. Okay, how much is its value? How it is determining for? So even for RC phase shift oscillator, we have done for BJT or Colpitts oscillator, right? So something 1 by 29, some factors we have determined. So if amplifier gain is 29, then beta factor should be 1 by 29 to satisfy the Barkha-Hassan criteria, which is loop gain equal to 1. So 29 into 1 by 29, it will give you 1, right? So same way, so you need to have some this one, okay? So what is the condition for loop gain, okay? Or the sustained oscillation. So not only generating oscillation is important, keeping the sustained oscillation. So that is given by this ratio. Okay. So in the case of Hartley oscillator, it is two inductors are there. That's why it's a ratio L1 by L2. And in the case of Colpitts oscillator, it is C1 by C2 determines the feedback factor. Okay. So it determines the feedback factor and thus must be adjusted in conjunction with the transistor gain to ensure that oscillations will start. Okay, so this factor, it will indicate the loop gain equal to 1. Okay, so this is about the Hartley and Colpitts oscillator introduction. Okay, so how was the circuit looking? So Colpitts oscillator, two capacitors in parallel with the inductor. In Hartley oscillator, two inductors in series, which are in parallel with the capacitor. Okay, so now we'll take up the analysis of Colpitts oscillator. Okay, as we have done BJT case, the same way we'll do the analysis of Colpitts oscillator. Okay. So this is the equivalent circuit. So whatever you have seen there, first figure A. Okay. So the transistor BJT is replaced by an equivalent model. So see here. So what you will have? So you'll have the input voltage. I have given the name as V5. Okay. Because hybrid 5 model. So the name is given. Any name you can give. VB also you can give. So I have given V5. Okay. And this is the transistor. And the transistor, so this, you know, transistor modeling, this dependent current source will come, transconductance into voltage GM into V5, okay? So internal resistance of the transistor, everything we have adjusted in this R only. We have told that in the explanation. So that's why this will come in parallel with the R, okay, which is connected to ground. So then we have the tank circuit. So how the tank circuit is connected? So instead of showing this C1, C2 here only, okay, I can show the C1, C2 here itself, right? So C1, C2, how it is connected? If I show you circuit only, then you will understand. Okay. let me go back and show you. So this is connected. Now R is over, transistor part is over. So now R another end, you have the capacitor there, C1 at the collector side. So this is the collector side, collector node we call C, right? So here C1 is connected, right? So then what happens? C1, there is a feedback, right? C1, there is a feedback went through inductor L to the capacitor C2 side. And this capacitor C2 is connected which side? The emitter side. Okay, where is the emitter? So, or the base side. Okay, so this is also connected to base side, one side, another is connected fractionally to emitter side. So instead of showing two series one side, it is shown around the transistor. Okay, so let me go to that figure, equivalent circuit, because that is the circuit we'll use it for analysis here. Okay, so if we see just the tank circuit, so they are connected as C1 is in series with C2, and that combination, so the C1 is in series with C2 and this combination is in parallel with L, right? So instead of showing over here, it is taken over here. Okay, because the fraction we are giving it to input also there. So emitter side we are giving. Okay, so base and emitter, it is connected. So see here, so this is the base side and this ground side is emitter, common emitter configuration. Okay, so it is not shown, you have to understand. And we have collector here. Okay, so this is the collector side. Okay, so we are applying the node analysis here to get the expression. Okay, so first we will understand detail whatever I have written here, equation. This only I will be using in expression there. So you have the input voltage V5. So you have the input voltage V5. So what will be the current in this capacitor? Current nothing but Ohm's law, voltage by impedance. Okay, if I have capacitance in Laplace transform, what is the equivalent of capacitance? So it is 1 by SC, right? So capacitor is there, 1 by SC will come, it is impedance. Okay, so now voltage by impedance. So when I take voltage by impedance, what will happen? So 1 by SC, so SC will come numerator. That's why here S into C2, capacitor is C2 and the voltage is V5. So that's why that is the current flows through this C2. Similarly, what is the current flows through C1? So it is same voltage because it is parallel, no? So same voltage, it will come over here. Okay. So, but what is the current? It is same way. So V5 into SC2. Okay. V5 into SC1, sorry. C1 is there. That's why that. So then this parallel combination, you have the inductor here. Okay. So the inductor side, so this is the same current it is flowing here, SC2 V5. So that only shown here. Okay. But what about the collector voltage? If we apply the collector voltage here, so what is this? It will be having, so it will be having the this voltage, input voltage V5. Okay. So this V5 voltage along with, it will be having the this one, okay, current into impedance. Okay, so this input voltage V5, which is same coming across here, it is entering here, this is the same voltage V5, and another voltage is coming through this path. What is that voltage? So that voltage is again given by impedance, sorry, current I into Z. Okay, Ohm's law. So what is the current in this? That is SC2 V5. So current is SC2 V5, and what is the impedance here? S into L. So it is in Laplace transform. When I convert, it will become S into L. Okay. And the current is SC to V5. So this is the upper part. So if I combine this, so what you will get? SC to V5. Okay. So S into S, S square, then L into C2. So S square L C2 into V5. V5 I have taken outside because here one is V5. That's why it is one I have taken. V5 into one is V5 plus S square LC to V5. Okay. So through this path. So that is combined. I have written over here because instead of writing over here, showing here, I have shown here. Okay. So don't confuse there. So it is through this path. No, it is together. The collector voltage, it is showing by this equation here. Okay. So this path voltage is this one. S square C, C2L V5. That is the voltage across that. Both will get added up and it will become V5 into 1 plus S square LC2. Okay. So now we will write the node analysis. We'll apply the node analysis at the collector. So we'll consider all the elements, GM, V5, R, C1, C2, L, everything we'll consider into picture, and we'll write the node equation. So from that only we have to start the analysis. So first you have to understand this figure, how I have written. Then what are the things I have written? You have to understand first SC2, V5, how it come, or this value, how it come. Okay. So all thing we are using Ohm's law. Okay. So next we'll continue the equation I will write. Okay. First I will show you the equation. Then if possible, I can come back and show you. Okay. First I will explain this circuit. To determine the oscillation condition for the Colpitts oscillator, we replace the transistor with its equivalent circuit as shown in figure. So when I'm discussing small signal equivalent circuit, I told you why we have to go for small signal equivalent circuit. If there is no small signal equivalent circuit, applying the KVL or KCL is very difficult for us. Okay. So that's why any transistor, active model or this one, we will replace it by equivalent circuit. So that's why this one. Okay. So here I have replaced the BJT with an equivalent circuit. So some of the things which we have not considered in syllabus. Okay. So in MOSFET part, we have went through internal capacitances, hybrid phi model, everything. But in BJT part in the syllabus, they have only this one, biasing itself and small signal operation. That's how we have studied. We have not studied the capacitances part and all. I don't know. It's incomplete discussion. If we take up that discussion, it is very lengthy. See, I have taken how many classes? I don't know so far. So still I'm in second module, not able to complete. Okay. And still many things are incomplete. Okay. So it's your responsibility. You can Google it and you can go through if you want. Okay. But not necessary. How much is necessary? I have taken them. That's why I'm not able to complete. Otherwise I would have completed three modules so far. Okay. Anyhow, we'll go through that. Okay. So here the same thing I'm discussing in second para, that is about capacitances in the BJT, which I have not considered. So that's why you may think it is something new. Okay. It's not new. So in the case of MOSFET, we have studied about gate to source, drain to source, four different capacitances. Same way in BJT, there are capacitances are there. So that I have neglected in this diagram. So to tell that, I have taken this paragraph. Okay, just we'll read out. To simplify the analysis, we have neglected the transistor capacitance C mu. So C mu, it will come at the input side. Same like a gate to drain for a FET. Gate to drain, same way it will be here based to collector capacitance it is. Okay, it is neglected. Then capacitance C5 also neglected, which is nothing but gate to source capacitance for a FET. So these are the very important resistance in the case of FET. You know, same way C mu and C5 is very important in BJT. So that also we have neglected here for this analysis of oscillator. Okay, although not shown, can be considered to be a part of C2. Okay, so the C2 capacitor we can consider. The input resistance R5, infinite for a FET, has also been neglected. R5 is included in R itself, right? Transistor resistor. So that's why R5 is again separately I have not shown. Because if I show it separately, then what happens? R5 is in parallel with R. So then compared to R, R5 is very small. It will be neglected. Only this analysis, just I have to explain there. Okay. I have to draw the circuit and then I have to show parallel connection, all this. Instead, I have written this in para everything so that you can understand. Okay. The input resistance R5 has also been neglected, assuming that at the frequency of oscillation C here, R5 much greater than 1 by omega C2. Okay. So finally, the resistance R includes the R0 of the transistor. Okay. R0, R5, different internal resistances and capacitances are neglected in my equivalent circuit. Okay. So next we'll write the equation and we'll see. Hope you are able to understand. That is a very important equation. If you remember that equation, further analysis, you can do it easily. Okay. So some more thing, to find the loop gain, we break the loop at the transistor base. Okay. Apply an input voltage V5. So how I have done there, I'm explaining that. I have transistor base. I have loop. I have breaked it. Apply an input voltage V5 there. And find the return voltage that appears across the input terminals of the transistor. And we then equate the loop gain to unity. Okay. So that is the thing we have done. And an alternative approach is two. So this is one way. Okay. So there are not always only one method. Multiple methods are there. So any method we can select. Okay. So whatever approach it is there in book, that only we'll go through. Okay. So what is that? Just look at an alternate approach is to analyze the circuit and eliminate current and voltage variables and thus obtain one equation that governs the circuit operation. This is what we have done in BJT and FET based oscillator, right? So we have taken the three equations, right? Loop equations, mesh equations. Then we try to form it as a single equation. And then we have combined the S substitution, S equal to J omega, we have done. And then we have separated out, okay, a real part and imaginary part. And then imaginary part we have equated to zero and we got the frequency of oscillation. Here we are not using that technique, okay? It is based on now this one, okay? So breaking the loop and applying the nodal analysis. Oscillations will start if this equation is satisfied, okay? Thus the resulting equation will give us the conditions for oscillations. That is the alternate approach which we have taken in the FET and BJT based oscillators in the previous sessions, okay? Okay, we'll see this first approach what they have mentioned, okay? So another way of analyzing for Colpitts oscillator we will look at. Okay, a node equation at the transistor collector, that is node C, I have shown in the figure, in circuit of figure yields. So what is the node equation there? Okay, so SC2V5, where is there? SC2V5, that is the current. Okay, so because all are in the same node, collector node only, everything. Okay, so all are in parallel, so they are in the collector. So one is SC2V5, first capacitor part is there, SC2V5. Then you have GM into V5. This is a current source, right? Current. So node equations means what? Kirchhoff's current law. Okay. All currents we are writing here. Okay. So current is nothing but voltage by resistance or impedance. So V5 by 1 by SC2 means SC2V5 came. This is already their current source, GM V5. Then you have two resistances. Okay. So the two resistances you have, what is that resistance? 1 by R and 1 by 1 by SC1. So 1 by 1 by SC1 will give you SC1. That's why it is there. And which will be multiplied with the voltage. Okay. So voltage into this one, conductance will give you the current. Okay. So what is the voltage at there? That's why I have taken this expression very first. So voltage at the collector I have written there above, right? V5 into 1 plus S square LC2 V5. Okay. So this is equal to zero. So only three terms are there. So now we'll go back and just check in the circuit. Okay. So then you will be able to understand it. This is the circuit. Okay. I applied the node analysis at the collector. So these all are at the same potential. Okay. So here across the capacitor, it is SC2 V5. It is SC2 V5. And then you have the GM V5, which is leaving the node. That's why plus GM V5. Then you have the R and C1. Okay. So it is conductance form. If you write how it will come, 1 by R and 1 by SC1. Because in Laplace domain, it is SC1 will be there. Okay. So 1 by 1 by SC1 will give you this 1 by SC1. So 1 divided by 1 by SC1 will give you SC1. That's why R plus SC1. That is the conductance. Conductance multiplied. Conductance means reciprocal of resistance. Multiplied by voltage will give you the current. So voltage is here, VC, V5 into 1 plus S square LC. So only these three part you have. And this inductor is already included in this expression for voltage. So no need to take it separately. Okay. So once you have understood this equation, we can do the further analysis very easily. Okay. So next what I am doing, V5 is common in both equation. So that's why V5 I have taken common. So V5 and here V5. So three parts we have and all the three V5 is common. I have taken that outside and whatever is there written, SC2 plus GM 1 by R plus 1 SC1, then 1 plus S square LC2 is equal to zero. Okay. So since V5 we could not take it as zero because already oscillations are started. So V5 means what? Input voltage. Input voltage after starting, you could not make V5 equal to zero, right? So instead what we can make, it can be eliminated. And the equation can be rearranged in the form. How it is elimination happens here? Zero by V5. So this V5 you take in denominator here, zero by V5, it will become zero. No need to tell this sentence also. Mathematically also it will vanish, okay? So what is remaining then? I have written here SC2 GM plus 1 by R, I am multiplying now. Okay, these two parts I am multiplying directly. 1 by r into 1, 1 by r. Next, 1 by r into s square lc2. S square lc2 by r it will come. Then this term, sc1 into 1 is sc1. Then sc1 into s square lc2. So s square s is there, s cube will come. And l is there, l. And c1, c2. Okay. So this is equal to 0 you got. So now what I will do? So now I will write it in s cube, s square and s form. Okay. In that form I will write. So s cube is this form. Okay. This is the s cube that I have written first. S cube, l, c1, c2. Then s square I have one term. That is this one. So s square if I take outside what is remaining? Lc2 by r is the coefficient. Then s form I have two terms. One is sc2, another is sc1. That I have combined s outside c1 plus c2. Then constant terms. So gm plus 1 by r is constant. That is taken at the last. So now it is like an equation, right? So a cube, a into x cube plus b into x square plus c into x plus b equal to 0. Like that expression. This is the form. Okay. I hope you understood till here. So now what I will do next step, I will substitute for s equal to j omega. Okay. So when I get s equal to j omega, I will get the frequency part. Then I can rearrange the equation. I will get the frequency of oscillation. That is our, game aim. No, that's what. Substituting s equal to j omega in the expression, what will happen? So s cube was there, j omega cube. S square was there, j omega square. S was there, j omega. Okay, here constant, nothing is there. Okay, so now we'll simplify. So when you have j omega cube, so what will happen? It is j square is minus 1. So minus j, 1 j will be remaining. So j square I will make 1. So it is minus j omega cube will come, right? So this is minus j omega cube will come. So here omega square is there and j square is there. J square means minus 1. So this plus sign becomes minus and this omega square lc to r, it will become a constant now. Okay. So j part is removed. Here j part is there. Okay. Here constant is there. So now what I will do, I will club the real parts and imaginary part. Directly I'm doing one step. I'm missing one step and I'm doing it because I hope you understand this. So first constant term, what you had, gm plus 1 by r, that I am writing first. And when you have the even square, only then j will cancel out. Okay. So this one remember. So j square is there, j4, j6, like that if you have, only then j term will vanish out. Otherwise, it will be there. So if we, it is vanished here. So what is the factor? Minus omega square C here written. Minus omega square LC2 by R. Whatever remaining is. So it is completely now the real part of the expression. Same thing we have done, no? In FET based, BJT based oscillator. Same way I am doing it. So this is the real part. Plus J. J I have taken outside here. See. So this is the J is there. So it is in plus form. This is minus form it is. Okay. So J form plus I have written first. Whatever is there, I have written inside. Omega into C1 plus C2. Then second J part, you have minus J omega cube. I told you, right? So this J cube becomes minus J. Because J square is minus 1. Minus 1 into another J is minus J and omega cube. Okay. So this if I consider, what is remaining here? Omega cube L C1 C2 equal to 0. So you got the equation 4. Till here, this is the analysis. Okay. So this is one type of analysis. Last class, what we have done, it is another analysis. Okay. I hope this is very simple compared to previous. So now we have come to the end stage. So just we have to equate the imaginary part. For oscillations to start, both real and imaginary part must be zero. For oscillation, when it is beginning, both will be zero. But to get the frequency of oscillation, we need to equate the imaginary part to zero. Equating the imaginary part to zero gives frequency of oscillation. What is the imaginary part? This one. Okay. So this is the imaginary part. This I equate it to zero. I will get the frequency. So what is that? I will denote now frequency as omega naught. Okay. Frequency of oscillation. Okay. Oh. Omega naught C1 plus C2 minus omega naught cube L C1 C2 is equal to zero. Okay. So we'll solve this. You'll get the frequency of oscillation, which I shown you in the very beginning for Colpitts oscillator, what it will come. Okay. So see here. Omega naught C1 plus C2 is equal to omega naught cube L C1 C2. I have taken right side. The minus sign becomes plus there. Then omega, 1 omega naught will cancel out here. So then what you will get? C1 plus C2 is equal to omega naught square L C1 C2, or if you write in this left side, rearrange the equation, omega naught L C1 C2 is equal to C1 plus C2. From this omega naught square is what? C1 plus C2 by L C1 C2, or this if you want to take it down. So it is 1 divided by L C1 C2 by, so this C1 plus C2, it will come in the super denominator. Okay, C1 plus C2. So this is indicating series combination now. Capacitor. So now this is omega naught square. If I write it for omega naught, it is 1 divided by square root of L into C1 C2 by C1 plus C2, which is the resonance frequency of the tank circuit. Okay. So this is the derivation for Colpitts oscillator. Okay. So if they ask Colpitts oscillator, the very first figure A you have to consider, then you have to start with equivalent circuit. And you have to apply the node analysis, write the equation, substitute for S equal to J omega, separate out the real part and imaginary part, and imaginary part to equate it to zero. So you'll get the oscillation. Just now try to show you whichever I told you it is coming same equation or not. Okay. So let me go back. See here in the discussion, I told you this, right? Colpitts oscillator 1 divided by square root of L C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. The same thing I shown you the derivation, how it came. Okay. Even if you want to write it in Hertz, F0, it is 1 divided by 2 phi, it will come here into square root of L C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. Okay. So that you can write it for Hertz. So similar way, you can do the Hartley oscillator, which is not shown in the book, textbook. That's why I'm not doing it. Maybe they will not ask the question on that. Okay. So you can do it in the same manner. Okay. Fine. So there are some more things are there to explain about, okay, the practical circuit of Colpitts oscillator, everything. So that I will consider in the next class. Okay.